when I got this book, I looked inside of it, and it just took me back to when I wished I could have been in basketball. Every time I go for the ball, I never know which direction to go, to that one or this one. But eventually I decided I was going to be something else. All of us have desires to be something else. And you know, we can all make it. All we got to do is just get off our duff and do our stuff. Now, I'll tell you, this story helps me remember about this poor little feller.
He was called Dewey. He was a shrew. And you know, he always wanted to be a basketball player, but nobody would ever let him be on. I could never get on their team. And so I go around to all of the basketball players in the forest. That's where we all lived. There we were, out there. I was the only one that would never be used. I would always just sit back there and wait because I was nothing but a little shrew. I was only about a thimble long. But I'd go out and I'd talk to some of the folks there in the forest, and oh, we had all of those folks. Look at them. That's where they were way up there, all of them. But not me. I was way down here. Nothing but a little thimble-sized shrew. And I wanted so much to be up there with the big folks. And I knew I could do it. And nothing's gonna stop me from doing it. Oh, I'll tell you. There was one fellow that I really had to convince, though. He was that great big bear. And he would look down at little old me.
Well, you gotta be tough. You gotta be big and strong if you're gonna play basketball. Now, you might as well remember it right now. Shrews can not hoop.
Oh, yes, they can. I think they can. And nothing's going to stop me, because some way or other, I'm going to make it.
Oh, no, you won't. Get out of my way. Here is what he looked like. And don't you forget it! Because he may end up right in your lap. All right. Now let's see who else was in that forest. Oh, yes.
Yeah! Ha, ha, ha! There was one fella, and he said, no. Hey, you must realize that if you are going to play basketball, you must be tall like I am. Not a little squirt like you.
Oh, and then
I went over. And I found some rabbits. Rabbits. I said, may I play on your team? Can I practice with you?
Us? No, no, we don't need you on our team. But you can't even bounce like we can.
So, you just better forget it. All of a sudden, I saw there were some rats in our forest, and they could bounce around, but I couldn't. So I just had to try and be at least as big as they were. But
you want to play basketball? No. Just remember this. Shrews can't hoop. Don't you forget it.
then he went to find another friend. Maybe he could get.
Can I play on your team? Please, Mr. Seymour Snail, I'd like to be on your team. You've got a nice big basketball. But you got all that slimy, gooey stuff all over your basketball. I don't know if you think I could use it once in a while to practice. But, now wait a minute. What has it got on that ball? Something written there. It says, property of Seymour Snail. Wow, that's your property? Well, you mind if I borrow it for a bit and try to practice? Well, I could learn. I know I could.
But you know what happened? All of the animals heard about this, and they decided right then they were never gonna let this little shrew get on their team.
Everybody's gonna have fun except me. And there he is, so sad, forgotten. But I know we could do it, Gesundheit. I knew we could do it. All we gotta do is just make up our minds. We can try. Nothing's gonna stop us. And then, I went down to the river. I knew of a friend down there that might help me. Just a great friend. A little turtle with a big thought in life. He knew he could do it. He knew what he'd been through.
Yes, 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 indeed. I've been through it all, and I can tell you right now, what seems to be your trouble, my young friend, can be helped only if you listen to my story, because this is a story about a turtle and a hare. Yes, yes. So let me tell you, a long, long time ago, when I was just a pup, everyone made fun of me, and I told them that I knew I could do it. It took me all day to tie my shoes. But somehow or other, I knew if I kept right on and kept working at it all the time, I knew I could beat that rabbit. And I did. And you know what? I believe you can do the same thing.
Me? Little old shrew me? But, well, I'd like to, but I don't know if I have what it takes.
And so you know what he did? He went home. He went to bed. He said his prayers because he's going to need them if he's going to get out there and practice. Practice. Practice to get better. Nothing is going to stop him. Somehow or other, he's going to make it. And we know he will. Yes, yes. And then he got up the next morning.
Wow, weights. And he got a hold of and getting a jump rope and running around, leaping from here to there. He even borrowed. I borrowed that ball from Seymour Snail. And I learned how to throw it. I knew I could. I could throw it in every direction. No matter what I was doing, they would all wonder, what in the world is that shrew doing down there? And I had to have something to show them. So I kept working away. And I throw it up and swish, swoom, swish, swoom. I'm trying to hit that basket. And somehow or other, I knew I was going to be able to do it. But then, of course,
yeah. What are you doing there?
Mr. Moose, please, just let me try.
Well, just forget it. You can't do it. You know, Schmooze can't hoop. Schmooze can't hoop.
Oh, yes, they can. Oh, yes, they can. And I see that ball. That's Seymour's ball.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the one I want. I want to have that ball.
But I see that it belongs to Seymour, and I can't even play with it.
Well, I'll tell you. Seymour is out having his tuba lesson today. So, I'm going to have that ball. And I'm going to throw that ball. And everybody in the whole forest is going to see how great I am. So, that's when I grabbed the ball. And I dribbled toward the basket. And I pumped my little legs as fast as I could. And as hard as I could until the pounding of the other animals chasing me around. Oh, they all heard that rat yell at me, "Step on him! Step on him! He'll never make it!" But I knew it was time. It was time for me to make my move, and I was going to. So I planted my little foot behind the free throw line, and I pumped with all my might, and I soared up, higher and higher and higher into the sky. Oh, that's higher than I'd ever jumped before in my life. And I sprang off of Moose's antlers, and I hopped right over the top of the rabbit's ears, and then I shot right for the rim. And I brought that ball back behind my head, and I slam dunked it. I slam dunked it right into that basket like it's never been slam dunked before. Well, oh, then all of the forest creatures stared in amazement as little Dewey, hung from the rim, and then, ever so gently, Bear reached up and grabbed Dewey and lowered the little shrew mouse down to the ground, down, and he declared in a deep, grizzly voice, he said, "We've acted quite awful.
really quite cruel. I feel like a heel. I feel like a fool. It isn't our place to tell others they're wrong. Instead, we should try to help them along. My small fuzzy friend, you've shown us all. You don't have to be big or fast to play ball. What you need is inside. It comes from your heart. Your desire and dreams will set you apart. We've been immature and caused quite a fuss. But today, Dewey Shrew, you're bigger than us! And everybody cheered for Dewey! Everybody cheered for Dewey! Everybody cheered for Dewey! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And then Bear grabbed Dewey's tiny paw and shook his teeth, clattering, and his arm felt like it was going to fall apart. But his little heart had the happiest feeling that he had ever had in his life. He was one of the gang.
I am one of the gang. I am one of the gang. I am one of the gang. I am one of the gang.
And then all the animals in the shade of a tree had a good look at what they were wondering, but they were mixed with glee. They were all enjoying a drink. And along with all the group, they all said, "Shrews really can hoop." What did they say?
Shrews
really can hoop. And I want to tell you, my friends, it's a good story that tells me what I want to do and how I got to be what I'm doing today. I thank the good Lord for the opportunity to meet wonderful people like you. And I'll tell you something right now. I don't suppose many of you know for sure, but I'm nearing my 82nd birthday.